video was made possible by EA Game Changers.
Welcome back, everyone. I have built a cul-de-sac in Albion Square. A comment was left on the last video by Yoon Seong-go, wishing that we could build, you know, or have different plots in the area that you could interact with at the same time. I was actually building this when that popped up on my screen, and I thought, absolutely, someone's connecting. And as I say, it would have been a different thing that the game would have given us, where you had different plots, because it's a very large space that you can move around in, but at least 3-4 plots across the way, across the zebra crossing, where you have different families with different last names living in those houses, and you can interact with those homes and have buses, taxis, you know, just for this special plot, just to bump it up a little in the game. Anyway, I've gone ahead to build 3 of these beautiful homes on this one plot, and it reminds me of exactly this time last year when I built the 3 Christmas Lake homes, and that actually reminds me of Albion Square. So I was thinking, should I recreate that here? And I thought, no, I want something different. And as soon as we got the game from the developers, I started working on this little project here, and I was so glad that it fit in 3 different houses, asymmetrical. The one in the middle is not asymmetrical, but the one to the left and right are asymmetrical. They are all 2-bedroom homes. They could be 3. You could, you know, make use of the basements, but I didn't do that in this case. I had 3 homes to design on the interior. That was enough work for me. Okay, we'll start with the first house. This house belongs to the Murphys. The couple have a toddler daughter, and this is what it looks like in AR. There are some clips in AR for the interior as well. And in this Albion cul-de-sac, this is the house to the left as you drive in. Okay, so you've met the first set of neighbors. That's the roof line. I really love the house. It's so cute. It's like something I could crack open and play with a doll on the inside of it. Okay, now we have the house that belongs to the Currens. They are also a family of 3, and this is a shot in AR for you. It looks like a typical chateau, doesn't it? And I'm using the black roofs in AR because we don't have the bluish type roofs that you have in the main gameplay. It's just one of those things, there are limitations. If it was my game, then I would have gone ahead and used the blue roof in AR. But yeah, they have a preteen son who lives with them. And then we have the last house in the cul-de-sac that belongs to Mr. and Mrs. Mulberry. They are childless at the moment and are trying to have a baby. This is what their house looks like. I think this is my favorite. I don't know why, but somehow when I finished building, it's just one of those things, but I got attached to the building. And I don't think it's the best house, but it's my favorite. Okay, now we're going to have a look at this little gate here. There are no glitches in this build. This is literally a 5x1 grid room, and I placed the garage doors on either side. And of course, those plants go in on the inside. And there you go, it's like a little gate, and your Sims have to come out that way. Alternatively, they could use the doors that lead out from their kitchens, okay? Now we're heading into the Murphys, and my realtor is going to take us around into the homes. That's the main front door as you come into the house and into this kitchen. This is why I love the L-shaped room. I get to tuck away a fridge, set it aback, and get it out of the way. There's a double door that leads into the grounds of the space for this house. And this is the reverse side of the kitchen here. And they have everything that they need to run a little space. And this is the grounds that I spoke of. So just for this house anyway, they can't leave the property unless they leave through the main gate. But the other ones, the doors lead out to streets. I love this little unit here with the gloves and the aprons and the little, you know, bits and bobs on there. This is the spiral staircase that you will unlock in the 12-day Christmas quest with Carol. And then as you cut across, again, I've got a coat rack in that L-shaped nook. And we're into the dining section of the house. So Mr. Murphy is here having a cup of tea. There would have been a piece of art on the wall, but I took it off because when I reverse this way, it blocks everything off. So I just took it off so you could have a good look. In AR, you get to see his wife, who's obviously just washing her hands again and checking on dinner. And you can see the piece of art across the way in the dining. So let me just get her to now pick up the rice. because she's going to do that very quickly. And she would then head off to the dining room where her husband is waiting for her. So this is the view in AR in the space. It's a small house, isn't it? But in AR, it gives you some more perspective and shows you that it looks real and spacious and realistic. At least that's what I think. So the fireplace is tucked away in a little nook here. And then you've got a little corridor that leads out to the backyard. In that corridor, there is a door leading into a restroom. And once you come to the back of the plot, it tilts and you have a bird's eye view. Okay, so this is what they have again in this corner, a very tiny space to get out. They can't leave the house unless they use the gate. The last space in this house downstairs is the living room toward the back here with the lovely bay window. I just really love that it doesn't have a platform in there. It's just a nice curved space. I use these beautiful chairs, some more Christmassy items, Moroccan pieces, a mixture of items in here. And it's a spacious living room, I have to say. I really love this fireplace. This is a shot in AR as Mrs. Murphy comes in here to enjoy some marshmallows. And it's interesting because when your Sims are eating marshmallows from the fire, they burn their mouth and yell. I'm not going to show you that clip. But yeah, this is where the television is. And now we're going to go upstairs to the last level of the house. Now we're going to pop up to a little landing, and in that teensy space I placed these two beautiful Sim Chase event chairs. Look at those beautiful windows, the lovely Moroccan light, and this door leads into the little girl Lily's room. She has a little balcony and it looks like a tower for a princess. Just look at this view, it's so cute. And look at that, she has her own balcony. But yeah, it's a very small room. But where she is with the dollhouse, you could place a closet there if you want. But I chose to put this dollhouse thing in there and keep her busy. And this is a view of her bed area. Very princessy, and I love the windows. Okay, now if we come across the hall past the little landing, you'll make your way into the large family bathroom. It's not a long walk for her at all. She just needs to pop across and make use of the very large space. It's got its own balcony as well. Isn't that fancy? And oh gosh, I just love the way when you're making mistakes as you build, it turns into a design. That's how these balconies came about. And I just absolutely love the oriel windows. And they've got the little laundry basket in here from the Household Blitz event, and tissue in here. I know it's for the kitchen, but I just wanted it in the bathroom. Now, the master bedroom is situated here. They've got a backdrop with that curtain and the stone walls and the Moroccan lamps and table lamps. They have their own closet space, which is enclosed. I love that. Isn't it a surprise that you get these spacious rooms in this small house, one of three on one plot? And Majam is now taking a nice hot bath, and no, the realtor can't come in here. That would be rude. Okay, it's bad enough he's already in the bedroom. That's the end of the Murphy tour. We're now coming to the Currents. This is the center house. As you drive in, they get annoyed because your headlights are on and it flashes in at night time, and you know, they pick their house, it's their fault. And I just love the design of the inside of this house. And all three homes have different floor plans completely, and different shapes. Again, there's no glitching in any of these builds, and moving forward, it's something that I want to steer away from, and it's a new direction that I have been inspired to take and be able to create beautiful designs without pushing. Now, this is what the bay windows look like in AR, and I stuck those countertops on the inside, and that allowed for me to put up these lovely Christmas trees, lights, incense, and it creates a beautiful backdrop for that lovely high back white chair. And you know, it just made it feel as though I could put more things in the space because it's quite small anyway. So it worked out as a design for a very teensy home to have that sort of character with these windows attached to it. Okay, so yeah, these chairs are very lovely. At first I thought, oh, white chair again, but no, it's fabulous. So it's an open plan space, a TV, a little corridor into a laundry space. I could have put a door there, but I didn't want to. I wanted it to be an opening just so you could have a look at the space. You can put a door, there is a restroom on the side here downstairs and a door leading out to the back alley, you know, outside of the street. Okay, now we're going to head off to the dining area here, past that camera, the Tudor camera. I really like that camera. But again, you see the same design running through into the dining area with those windows. I think it's a great idea. I just prefer that it had the same color with those countertops anyway. I'm sure you could try something else. So we've got a fireplace in this dining room, a little mirror, a Moroccan one, a phone on the wall, and their son Jared is playing away with the new household Blitz device. And you can see the Sims Free Play on the screen. And here's the kitchen tucked away. We've got the fridge, dishwasher, microwave in that corner, and then the rest of the kitchen in this spot here. So it's next to the dining room, as you can see, looking over into that space, and I think it's situated in the right spot in this teensy little build. I really love these little homes, and I just can't believe they all fit in and have enough space and so on. But yeah, I'm very pleased with the outcome. I certainly am. So the kitchen has everything, including cabinets, right, with plates and so on, and the lovely oriel window, one of my favorites in the game now. But that's everything for the ground floor of the Curran family home. And then this fabulous black Moroccan stairs with a red color on the steps is just so pretty. That takes us up to this landing, a very unique landing at that. So you work your way around into that L-shaped space, and on the side here is a little door that brings you out to this balcony for the front of the house. So it looks like he's the king of his castle. He sits on one of those chairs and he can see the snow, the neighbors, see who's coming in the front gate and so on. I just think it's a lovely little section for the house with that red brick in the back there. Okay, so that's the way out to that area. And then when we come back in this way, right across the way, you come to a large family bathroom. Again, very big bathroom, okay? And again, those oriel windows. You're going to see a ton of them in the next house we're coming up to, so don't get tired of it. But it's a large family bathroom that Jared uses anyway, because the parents' bedroom is an ensuite. This is his room, and you can see the little stand where the device would go. Okay, his blanket sticking out of that drawer. It's your typical little preteen boy's room. It's fun to look at this way, nice and messy. And his own little wardrobe section on the side there. Okay, so we'll come out from that room and into the master bedroom on the side here. So I use the French bed. Again, this isn't my game, but I built in the game and used the furniture pieces that I could find. And I didn't want to repeat furniture pieces in the different homes. So I love the way this looks. They got the oriel window again, a closet on the side, a little section here for a chest, a drawers, pictures, bags, and so on. And then, of course, they've got their own master bathroom. The L-shaped feature allows for me to hide away the toilet unit in a private corner. And that completes the tour for the Curran family house. We have one more house on the left as you come into the Albion cul-de-sac. And somehow we are blocked, so I'm going to have to return this cream wedding limo out of the way to the parking area where it belongs so that we can get in. Now, they don't have limos, no. It was just as a prop for family photos and so on. That's what it was there for, as they can't afford, you know, limos. Now, this is my favorite build. It was the last one I had to do, and so I took my time. I love the magical Morocco balconies, the oriel windows, the pot in the entrance, the Christmas door. All the collections are in here, and even in the entrance I stuck a Christmas tree, and none of the houses had a Christmas tree on display. This tree is right by this window, so you can imagine the light would sort of sparkle out of it into the little street there. And on the opposite side we have this divan from the Morocco event. And then, you know, you've got an open plan space. Again, floor plans are completely different in all the houses. And this is what I used for the dining section. Farmhouse chairs, Moroccan table. We've got the tinsel up on the wall. Let's just turn some of these on, or both of them. They're the only two in the house. Yeah, it's a very Christmassy space. They've gone all out, and they've got this little bay window here that I created. Yeah. It just basically opens up right across to the living room area with a middle section here that leads into a laundry and restroom space. It's quite small, but it's functional. And they also have a back door you know, leading out to the street. So this is where we have the living room with the fireplaces on both ends, chimneys, right? The television is in this bay section here. And I use these chairs from the fine dining live event and the Moroccan piece up on the wall. This is the view in AR. Okay, lovely fire, telly in the bay window, the couple, the Mulberries, who haven't got a baby yet. I'm hoping that they do. It's been a few years they've been married, but they're happy together without, and hopefully they would have a child soon. And this is basically what the space looks like in AR. Okay, very nice. It looks larger than it does, and that's the kitchen. Very small kitchen, but it's got everything you need. Everything you need. The bay window is white on the inside and a white chest of drawers. I thought that was a nice match and pop of color in the space, or pop of no color. And this is the view from the dining across the way to the living space. Okay, the dining chairs are different because the ones I have in normal gameplay aren't in AR. All right, now we're going to have a better look at the kitchen, which is basically a 3x3 room that is then an L-shaped room by a 3x2 where the stairs is. The thing is, with a kitchen, all you need is the microwave, a cooker, some countertops, cabinets, a sink, and a fridge. If you've got all those things and a space to stand in, you're good to go. And that's what I have here. And I'm really pleased that I was able to squeeze this kitchen in. So yeah, it's a functioning space. And this is that 2x3 space where the silver Moroccan stairs are situated. And I put a little bay window just to burst the space up to match the landing area and the shape of the build at the back, you know. And yeah, when you come up to that landing, you've got this beautiful little small dainty space. You've got a single high back chair, a double high back chair from the Christmas Carol event, and it's some sort of an L shape into this section here. I always try to build realistically, so there's a lot of light coming in from those windows into this L-shaped space. You've got the guest bedroom on the side here. I love the freshness of this room, the brick, the feature wall, the bed, the different color of walls on different sides of the room. They've got a TV in here, and guess what? A private balcony and a closet space all fit into a 3x1 room that then leads out to this little 1x2 balcony with this little tree in there. I can't tell you how pleased I was when I was able to do that. I thought, yes, finally, another different design. This is the hall bath that the guest room would make use of. This bathroom has three oriel windows that make the house look quite pretty on the front. I think it's very cute. And then you've got the master bedroom right here. And I use that bed from the Desert Oasis live event. It's so nice in here. The colors are warm and rich. And the Moroccan lamps, it all goes together. So you have an idea of how some of these pieces will work together. As I said in the early access videos, they will go with other items in the game. They absolutely would, while some might not. Of course, the master bedroom has a closet, private balcony. We'll see that later. But they've also got an ensuite bathroom. They've got a tub, some flowers, a toilet unit, sink. And of course, the most important part of this space is that lovely tinsy oriel window. By the time I keep going on about these oriel windows, you're going to be fed up with it. Okay, so of course they've got a matching balcony as well to look out onto the cul-de-sac. And that's the end of the tour for all three buildings. Now, which one is your favorite? I really love this whole setup. The back parts of the house were important to me in that they had to be designed in a way that fits the street. You know, I didn't want it to look like a mess. It had to look pretty for the street as well. So that's something that I had to keep working on as I was designing the inside, shifting, breaking down walls, changing. It worked out brilliantly, and I will build this when I do, if I do complete the quest. Even this house here that you can't see quite well, gives you a little sneak peek of the design to the rear. So which one is your favorite? Let me know in the comments down below. I will be obviously taking a break from YouTube till the new year, but some or a couple of videos are going to come up that have already been pre-recorded. I will check in every now and again to see the comments and interact, and I will see you again soon in the next video. Have a wonderful Christmas. Take care. Bye.